So previously, we saw how we could take a couple of strings and combine them together by using that little plus operator. Now, we've already seen this slide, and if you take a look at the code, in particular that fourth line, what you're going to notice there is there's a lot going on. That I've got that little plus right there in the middle with my string literal, and then I've got another plus here, and another string literal, and another plus here, and another string literal. And you know, this can get unwieldy pretty quickly. And you know, this is not even taking into account that we might want to be calling capitalize or upper or lower or some of those other helper functions that we might have. And our code's just going to keep getting longer and longer and longer. So let's try and simplify this a little bit. And this is where our format strings come into play. That what we can do is that little output that we see up at the top, where again we're calling that plus sign that we've already seen, or we can streamline this by using placeholders. Now, each one of these outputs that you see up here on the slide is going to give us the exact same string. We're just going to do it slightly differently. So the first one, what we're doing here is we're going in and we're putting in placeholders with those curly braces. Now the way that this works is it's going to be based on the order in which we specify the parameters. So that first one there, that's going to be first name in my case. And that second one, that is going to be last name. Now, if we wanted to specify it, what we can do instead is we can use the 0 and the 1, which then allows us to specify the first and the second, respectively. Remember that counting will start with 0, so that 0 is going to be the first item, and the 1 is going to be the second item. Now, in my example up here, it's not going to make a difference that both of them are the exact same. But if I need to potentially reuse the exact same string somewhere else, or maybe I just want to document it, show, hey, this is going to be the first, this is going to be for the second, this is going to be for the third, then I could go ahead and put in that 0, the 1, and then maybe a 2 later on as well. Now, the last example that I want to highlight here, and I want to make sure that I point out the fact, whoops, that was not what I wanted. I wanted that. There we go. I want to make sure that I point out the fact that this is only available in Python 3. So if you're doing anything that needs to run in Python 2, this last example is not going to work, but it will work in Python 3. And that is where I put in F right at the very beginning, F being for format. And now what I'm able to do, and I love this functionality, is I'm able to now just use my variable names right in line with everything else. This is my preferred method whenever I'm doing string concatenation because it's nice, it's clear, it's self-documenting. You always want your code to be self-documenting. And when somebody comes back, assuming that they understand the little F at the beginning, it's very easy for them to go, oh, that's going to be my first name, and that is going to be my last name. Let's see how all of this works inside of code in our next little video.